When the quake hit, villagers were outdoors working, which probably lowered the death toll in the rural areas. Yes, we heard the noise and ran for safety. We were standing here and could feel the shake, as one of the victims says. Thousands of houses were destroyed across many of the country's districts, with entire villages flattened, especially those near the epicenter. Nepal, with a total GDP of $19.921 billion, is one of Asia's poorest countries. It lacks the ability to fund a major reconstruction effort on its own. Many countries, international organizations, and groups have come to rebuild this broken land. There are many remote areas where the people are still in need of help.
Since last 10 years, the Little Flower Society, which the Little Flower Congregation run in Nepal, was focusing on Chepang indigenous community of Nepal, one of the most vulnerable communities, tribal communities of Nepal. We came to know within 3 or 4 days that many houses of the Chepangs were destroyed and they were homeless and staying in forest areas and roadsides.
बैशाख 12 गते आको भूकम्पले मेरो 6 नम्बर वार्ड चितवन जिल्ला रथर गाविसमा घर के छैन, स्कुलको व्यवस्था नि के छैन, अझ सरकारले पनि हेला छैन, हेरा छैन, कता कता संस्थाहरू पनि हेरा छैन। घर त मेरो त अहिले त जस्ता छाना मात्रै छ, सबैको मेरो चाहिँ छाना मात्रै छ। अरूको यही बासबङ्गामा अहिले गएर हेर्नु, छाना नि छैन, उनीहरू गोठमा छ। मेरो त झन् गोठ नि छैन, एउटा सानो गोठ थियो, त्यो गाई बाख्रा मात्रै छ, सुत्ने ठाउँ छैन। सुँगुरमा सुत्यो सुत्यो, अहिले घाँस घिज्रा दुख्ने गरी ढुङ्गा माटो फालेर त्यही घरमा बसिरहेको छु म। पानी पऱ्यो भने भित्र पस्छ झर, तिरपाल तागिने तिरपालमा यति यति पानी आउँछ, एकदम दुःख छ हाम्रोको गाउँमा अहिले। बैशाख 12 गति आएको भएको मैले।
Understanding the situation, priests from the Little Flower School at Narayangarh in Chitwan, known as the CST Fathers, came to rescue affected people.
When this earthquake has taken place, I was on my way back to Chitwan. We could feel that it had a serious effect on both humanity and structure in Nepal. As soon as I reached my office, I called a meeting of the head of the departments and we swim into action.
Under the leadership of Father Robi, the school management analyzed the situation and started work on an immediate rescue and relief project in the remote areas.
We are on our way to Jogedi village. where many houses are completely destroyed by earthquake. Nothing. Hope we will able to reach there soon and able to help them and to console them.
Some of the remote areas were not reached by relief agencies or other organizations. This is due to lack of transportation and the difficulty in reaching those areas.
To reach these relief materials to different places was a Herculean task, as the settlements of Chepangs are in high hills. We had to hire vehicles, as walking to those places was almost impossible. And even the vehicles reached even 5 hours from the highway to reach their location. And people were extremely happy to receive those things, relief materials.
Day or night, roads or no roads, they made a point of reaching out to them.
Even though it was very difficult to reach some of the affected areas, we found the joy of helping the affected people.
Some of the scenes from the earthquake-affected areas are truly heartbreaking. Women with children in shabby clothes come to you, expecting a helping hand. Many lost their beloveds, their dear ones and neighbors. A situation where they have no roof or food, but only tears for the victims. The most important thing was giving immediate medical care to the survivors.